Are you filming, Dave? You got
yep.
this? So, again, one of the interesting things that a lot of people don't recognize is that if I grab a hold of a gun, they think, oh man, it's just gonna rip my hand off, all right? But it's not. It's not gonna rip your hand off. You think about this, if I pull this out, and here I have a 9mm, it's got that much powder in it, okay? It's got 350 foot-pounds of energy coming out the end. That's all the recoil in the back that it's going. When you watch people that actually get shot, what it feels like to them is getting punched in the chest, okay? That's what it really feels like getting done, or punched in the gut. Now, is that hurt? Sure. But what really starts to impact them is the blood loss a second or two later. So what really happens is that if I pull this trigger and I have a hold of this barrel, okay, so if I'm, again, I'm trying to stay, you know, this side of the firing line here, right? But if I had a bad guy that had this gun and I had to grab a hold of it, and I say, can I live through that? Is that gonna happen for me? Well, not if I try to teacup it, right? If I'm like, oh, it's very nice and pinky out, you know, then I'm not gonna do well with this, of course. But if I realize this is life or death, boom, I'm gonna grab that for everything it's worth and just hold on tight and hope for the best. It's not nearly as bad as I think it is. This guy's, my hands are all nasty with the sunscreen. But if I hold that and I start pulling that and I pull the trigger, right? So here I am and I have a hold of this and I pull the trigger. Are you freaking out, Kara?
A little.
Why are you freaking out?
Because don't shoot yourself, please.
I'm really not gonna shoot myself. Do you notice that? So if you wanna come and inspect, I don't wanna point it away from us, but you can see that here I have, and I have this guy and my hand is on the inside. So all the dangerous end is that way, okay? So again, I'm gonna go ahead and just pull the trigger on this. It's upside down.
Your pinky is near the ejector.
Yeah, you're right, it is. My pinky's absolutely right next to the ejector. This isn't a blowback gun, so I'm not gonna have any problems with it.
Okay.
Okay? So again, if I pull the trigger.
Ooh.
How far back did it go? You can see, look at how far back it went.
Yeah.
Do you see that? It went back what?
Quarter
a centimeter?
Inch.
Quarter of an inch? Yeah. Something like that? Okay? So now, how badly did it hurt my hand? It really didn't. Okay? And now?
Nothing.
Nothing. Why? Because
it didn't recycle. Another round.
Because when I pull this out, what happens is
it did not
my
cycle.
Spent case. So what happened is I put this guy, I ceased the cycle from sliding. And it didn't, guys, it doesn't hurt. It's probably something that I would recommend if you have the guts to do right now. To say, so again, if I pull it, this isn't an isolated incident. I turn upside down just because it's a little easier to do, because this is kind of awkward to do over my shoulder, right? But again, even if I don't, even if I put my hand on it on top, okay? And I say, okay, wait a minute, what about this? Okay, so what happened? How far back did it come? You can see again, how far back did it come?
Barely. Yeah, just another quarter inch.
Quarter of an inch, right? Didn't hurt nothing, how's my hand?
Greasy.
I got a little greasy black stuff, right? There it comes out. Why isn't it gonna go off again? It's not gonna go off because the cycle didn't slide. When I pull that, there it goes. There's my spent case.
It's a lesson not many people know.
So we think that the reality is that, okay, wait a minute, if I grab a hold of this gun and I push it up over his head, right, then he's gonna shoot it and it's gonna rip my hand off and then he's gonna kill me with it. No, because we gotta get out of Hollywood, okay? Hollywood doesn't help. Anybody wanna try?
Ooh, I don't know.
I will.
I don't care.
Okay, what am I doing?
Okay, so you're gonna grab...